technique, tactics, attack, defense, pattern. Back to the board, the rugby analysis.
Welcome to the show once again. This week we'll be looking at Candy versus Sia's analysis and also James Haskell's high tackle on Jamie Roberts, the Harlequins center, which went for a controversy, perhaps according to the letter of the law, which was the right decision by the referee to award a red card. Now, Candy versus Sia, it's always hard to be the defending champion, especially at Nitavela grounds. Sia made few changes, we'll talk about that. But this man, Reeza Raffaideen, in the wing three quarter for Sia and FC, in the first 10 minutes itself, he was making some valuable tackles. That was on Danushka Ranjan. It's not easy, but perhaps I'm not sure whether Danushka's fending ability for the left hand is his weaker point, because we have seen many tries he's scoring from his right hand fend off. But again, never give up attitude to tackle that Srinath Suryabandara. Also, he was taking his mark early on, Richard Dharmapala, so not allowing space to run. But for the first 10 to 14 minutes, they were brilliant. Again on Richard Dharmapala, not letting off to beat him. So one-on-one defense was absolutely spot on by CRNFC's wing three quarter Reeza Raffaideen. You can see, we know that Richard Dharmapala is also another dangerous guy, especially one-on-one attack. And there will be another incident again, this time on Jason Dishanayake, not letting it go. He misses in the first time. So how often we have seen a wing three quarter tackling as many as this much in one game? And the first real mistake in that 13th minute for Sia, because in this scrum the decision making was not that right. But more than that, the Candy's defensive work in that 5-meter scrum. Look at Tarun Chaturanga, the flanker, and Shayan Lema Pathirana up like a flash, and no chance for Omalko Gunaratna. Perhaps they could have sent the ball to Kushan Indunil at the center and ask him to go for a hit. Kavindu Perera can support, so as the flanker, Sia flanker could have support, but that didn't happen for Sia. Tarun Chaturanga saw that loose ball coming out from that base, and he just places the ball in the wide force to get that 5 points for Candy. And since then, it was raining tries for the defending champions in that game. It was brilliant from that try. And the main incident in this game, not sure whether Sia opted their starting 15 correctly. We saw skipper Kavindu Perera from that usual wing three quarter position. He's combining in the second centre along with Kushan Indunil. If you ask me who are the two standout players for Sia's this season, I would pick Tarindra Ratwatri from the backs and Charna Chamikara among the forwards. But unfortunately, he was not starting in this game. He came off the bench at the 77th minute. It was just a consolation try. If you want to beat Candy in their own end, or if you want to put some show at least, you have to pick your top starting 15, because sometimes attack is the best way of defense. And also, looking at this try by Candy, it's a sensational set piece work, because look at the offload, Danish Dayan, and sending it to Danushka Ranjan. But one must say it's a poor defense by CRNFC, but on the other hand, it's a world-class try by Candy, because during the warm-ups they were doing quite brilliantly. They were doing as many as time comparing to the opposite team, so they just execute what they did in the warm-up into the action at the actual match. So that was a brilliant try to watch from Candy. And the other incident we picked up from the international arena, James Haskell tackle on Jamie Roberts, the Harlequin center. But it went to a controversy whether is it intentional, reckless, and looking at that, his shoulder just going into Jamie Roberts' face. So anything above shoulder height, it is going to be a penalty offense. But this time, perhaps according to the letter of the law, but there's a good camaraderie by James Haskell also, referee awarding a red card. So all I want to point out is that school season, it's not far from us. So all the school coaches must know this law, because the modern law, you can't go for that seat belt tackle and you can't go reckless into the player's neck, because player's safety is paramount, because the World Rugby have understood how critical is that concussion. They want to put that concussion into a minimal in this hard-fought game of rugby. So that's all for the Back to the Board segment, and we'll see you next week with more action.